So there we go. One extra game. This time it's gonna be a learning experience for Shadowfax as Shelty is trying to show him how this matchup is supposed to be played. So two dots. Joe and Shelty playing Water in Hole for the third time. And it's gonna be yet again Isis versus Thor. So Thor being right now spawned at the bottom, yet again gonna be having quite nice hunt in there as usual. The forward goal doesn't really matter a whole lot to him. And so far we don't see a whole lot more. But Rhino on the left side, so he does have really plenty of food that he wants to choose from. That's of course gonna be usual on map like Watering Hole, as he's already coming forward. Right now Joe for his hunt as well, he's diving back gold mine, so there's definitely gonna be quite a nice bonus for him. He's gonna be happy about that, but otherwise he definitely will be hoping that the map is gonna be slightly more forgiving than the last one. And finally there's gonna be maybe an opportunity how to wall slightly better. Yeah, there's a gold mine for him, that's kind of reasonably positioned. Considering though that he does have the TC on the other side of the TC. Well, the base TC, it's kinda not great, but I would be expecting there's gonna be another gold mine here. Because that's how often the map spawn there, and there's gonna be back TC of course for Shelty, and he's gonna be having quite a lot of gazelles right here. With another very interesting gold mine, but it almost seems like that the water might be moving there. Yeah, there's a water. In here, there's gonna be a water patch. So it seems that this is gonna be coming all the way about here, and then that's gonna be rather ending. Let's see if there's gonna be passage into the middle of the map or not. So basically deciding if that goal is gonna be safe. Whereas Joe is right now at the top side, discovering plenty of hippos. Plenty of hippos indeed, but so far no extra gold, as the piggy is helping with a bit of scouting there as well. So far not much to talk about, because we haven't really scouted too whole lot. There's gonna be a front TC for Shelty. That is kinda interesting position. So far we don't really see if there's any gold mine around it, so the map control position of that is not exactly huge. Might be possibly expecting Joe's TC somewhere in here in the middle. Somewhere right in the middle in there, gonna be getting a bit more information once the obelisk is gonna be finished. So far a few more piggies on the left side, some hippos. So plenty of food for Shelty right around this base, so it's definitely nice, but here again we are on Watering Hole. So that's kinda to be expected and is presupposed. Joe apparently having a bit of fun here. Having a bit of nice fun. And there's a gold mine and there's a front TC for Joe. Yeah, well, Joe should be getting a bit more right now. A bit more nervous because his front TC is kind of sucky. Joe just saying it might go Anubis. Yeah, well, I don't really think so. That's gonna be a bit of a mind game. And mind game's right there. Yeah, well, definitely right now saying that. But unfortunately, Shadowfax, they cannot see you for obvious reasons. So we can basically right now say that only to me. And kinda not sure if you actually see my chat. I'm really curious if he should. I think that he should. So maybe I just need to also switch to everybody. I don't know. I think that it's actually right now at custom and start. We should be communicating with each other. And he should be seeing it like all the chat in the game. So basically, we don't need to select anything. We just seen all the chat in the game as an observer. So he should be seeing that as well, as I'm seeing his, basically for the same reason. So yeah, that's gonna be it. As right now, of course, Shelty is gonna be scouting that his opponent is on the hippos to the top side. So the walling is yet again gonna be kinda difficult for Joe. As we're looking all around. He already should be working on that a whole lot more as we are at about 3:40. So the advance time is gonna be kinda heading there, but apparently not yet. Shelty is gonna be advancing at about 4:50, 5 minutes. That's kinda okay. Not really that tragic so far. Maybe could have advanced slightly faster. But really for a widget eye for cheaper myth units, it's kinda interesting. Might be useful actually on vanilla, where the myth units are all quite expensive. So let's see about that. But in the meantime, Joe is apparently gonna be having plenty of room and time to finish with everything. Widget Eye is here. Yeah, well, nice for him. But let's see if he's gonna be really using it or not. This is thinking that he might be really coming for the Anubites, but no, he's coming for the bust. Just basically playing a bit of mind games with his friend Shelty. So kinda why not? Coming for the golds with 5 villages so far. Plenty of gazelles, but where is he gonna be moving next? I'm thinking he might be moving actually here into the cranes. As probably right now it would be just a bit too late to come anywhere else. As apparently Shelty is gonna be locking him in. So that he cannot really escape anywhere all that easily. That's definitely a nice idea. And then it should be probably continue with Wallin also here as well. It is actually quite nice. Oh, come on, Joe. Come on, Joe. Don't try to be too clever. Don't try to be too clever on your opponent. Now, so I just wanted to talk about the fact that Joe is fully connected to Shelty through the backside. You can see this is fully connected. So very important Wallin is gonna be here, and if Joe doesn't take it, I don't think he has scouted properly all the way to the bottom. So he might be falsely assuming that this is basically all gonna be somehow... He might be maybe looking at this. Some kind of depression there that he has seen a part of and hoping that it's basically coming all the way. But no, it isn't. It isn't, so this could be definitely a way for the red player, not for those villagers, but of course for the first army to come quite surprisingly all around into the back of his base. So... good luck dealing with that, because that wouldn't really be all that nice surprise for Joe. Let's see. Yep, we see our chat. ShadowFX and me, we can communicate without any kind of problem, but they're not gonna be seeing our chat there. Got pig stuck behind forest wall, really? Ah, well, he kinda really does. He kinda really does. Yeah, three piggies stuck for him. No, they cannot see ours. That would be obviously kinda weird. If observers could be telling every player in the game what is actually going on in there. Yeah, definitely. Exactly, that's what's going on in there. Trying to basically put Shelty out of his game. Right now coming with, of course, the Prosperity. He's kind of a bit faster than maybe you could be thinking. I'm really kind of curious about this, because sometimes you see Egyptians really cast it. The same goes for Rain. A bit faster, or rather quicker, than they are having all the villages ready. I'm kind of curious if it really makes that kind of significant difference for them in advanced times, or if it's really just wasting resources. I'm not really sure about that. How it actually works, but if he already had the resources to click into Nephthys, I think it would be wasteful. It would be wasteful not to use the full prosperity with all the empowerment and with all the villages. But yeah, well, it is definitely gonna be coming on the left side. Exactly, that's gonna be the problem for Joe. Yet again, he's gonna be failing to wall up. And this is exactly something that ShadowFX should have used. Should have used in the last game, but he just didn't. And yeah, they're actually fully hidden in there. All three piggies are gonna be there for probably the rest of the game. And those forests, well, in the middle, I'm kinda not sure, but George is basically fully right now underestimating the wall in. And this is right now gonna be double raiding coming from Shelty, right on the right side and on the left side as well. But he doesn't have anything to raid on the left, unfortunately for him. Whereas on the right, right now this is gonna be solid update. Solid upgrade time for Joe at 7:27. That's basically the best one of the three watering holes that we have seen so far. And it's gonna be making things a whole lot harder for Shelty to properly punish him. As he's right now forced into the Migdol stronghold in the defense. But what's gonna happen next? That is the, right now, quite a bit question. Because at this point, Shelty still does have... Oh, he doesn't. He actually went through Forseti. He didn't go through Freya. So he, if he went through Freya, he could have cast Forest Fire there and destroyed about maybe the tower. Well, probably not the tower, as the wood line is not right next to it. But he could have destroyed at least two houses. And it already would have been problematic. And he, of course, much more than anything, would have basically forced his way in into the enemy base. So yeah, you can also see a lot of extra information for ShadowFX given to you in there. These have been plenty of villages on the gold mine in there, as Joe was finishing with the Migdol without any kind of problem whatsoever. And right now with the healing spring being cast somewhere at the base, yeah, he doesn't really want to risk losing it all that much. There is gonna be Braggy coming forward at about 9 minutes, that's solid timing for him. Quite solid timing for him, but the save gold mines is exactly the problem for Joe, as unless there is one about here, he will have to develop himself somewhere into the middle, and probably towards this one, or maybe even this double, as it's gonna be really difficult. His front TC is kinda sucky. Well, it's kinda sucky, but it's gonna be kinda curious how actually the opponent is gonna be playing this, because he lost plenty of units right about now, and Joe is gonna be having all the opportunity in the world to push forward, maybe even drop a Migdol in there, rather than dropping the town center at this point. It's gonna be a really curious decision for him to make, as I can kinda understand the strength of both of them. But right now with the Braggy, and of course the flaming weapons being here, it's gonna be all about proper timing of course, the Eclipse, not really so much of the Ancestors, but rather the Eclipse, to deny potentially the flaming weapons in some kind of interesting and important engagement for the opponent. Okay, so army coming forward. Army coming forward, trying to check the TC out. Is he gonna be already sending the villages in there? So far he isn't. But he's sending basically all the army that he can possibly spare in that direction. Being right now at the last 500 gold, so he really needs to do something significant and probably needs to be a migral in the between those gold mines, I'm thinking. That's what needs to happen, but the army is really strong at this point for Shelty. Like, seriously strong, and we are at 10 minutes at this point. And he's basically almost popped, well, maybe even fully popped. You can see that he's already having medium raiders even upgraded, maybe even copper shields right there. He's playing very well indeed at this point. So Shelty is on top of him, and he is denying. Yep, this is a denial of flaming weapons, absolutely. Absolutely denial of flaming weapons, because he was feeling it, and it really looked like a good opportunity for Shelty to actually go for it. So that would really be something nice for him, but Joe is definitely denied, and I'm fully expecting villagers coming forward. Yep, gonna be coming the TC. Coming for the TC, because at this point the flaming weapon still could be quite deadly after, and he will need to produce a whole lot more. I think he should be just basically then spamming buildings around the TC to keep it alive as long as possible. It's gonna be kind of difficult. He's having only like 25 seconds more, because as soon as the ancestors are gonna be gone, that's a very nice protection right now. Oh, just no, didn't finish fast enough. Bit of a failure right there. Yep, he's gonna be caught in a bit of a battle there, but he does have plenty of heresies right now. So the ancestors are gonna be easily dying. And Joe should be already kind of falling back and discovering what else he could be doing. But I really hold that he should be producing military buildings around the TC. Like right around the TC, because he has to be aware. But with the size of the enemy army, he cannot fight it even next to the TC with the flaming weapons. Yeah, I think this is a mistake. He should have made it right next to the TC to protect it as much as possible. I really think that's a mistake right now by Joe. Because he definitely... Flaming weapons are gonna be coming just about now. I fully expect that he's gonna be casting it now and punishing his opponent quite significantly. Extra upgrades not yet for the opponent neither. That's expected for the Egyptian, as he is on the gold mine on the right side, but he doesn't have any kind of protection. Should be really walling somewhere about in the middle in there. But let's go back into the main battlefield, where exactly mercenaries are gonna be spent. But you can see that Joe doesn't have gold for that. He doesn't have gold even for mercenaries. Well, that's absolutely horrible. Send the villagers outside so that he can already prepare for a repair, which is definitely gonna be needed. As right now, Joe is gonna be completely slaughtered. But yeah, the losses for Shelty are definitely not huge there. And Joe is gonna be right now resigning, because that is exactly how we can punish such a forward TC. With Joe, I kinda think that it was risky. I can see the justification for that, why he did that. But at the same time, he probably needed to secure the goal a bit more. And if he did go for the TC, he definitely needed to produce a whole lot more military buildings around, maybe even just towers. Because it was just absolutely obvious that he would be heavily punished by the flaming weapons. Yeah, the ancestors block. It seemed like that actually it wasn't even in the end the plan for Joe to actually block the flaming weapons, interestingly. Huh. That's a bit of a disappointment. I was thinking that might have been really blocked, because it really looked like a situation where Shelty might want to cast that and have a bit of fun with the opponent. But yeah, well. Yeah, those spearmen are not a bad idea. When you see the Thor producing so many horses, cannot hurt. Yeah, Kimmels are not exactly great without the Wobbly Balance patch. But versus Raiding Cavalry, that's... yeah, well... Spearmen are gonna be better, always, because... Camels are not heavy counter, or rather hard counter, they're kinda soft counters, so that means... they don't exactly have a huge bonus or anything like that, they just less sucky than other types of units. So they are recommended to make against horses. Yeah, Spearman, Chariot, Archer, that's definitely a good combination. Let's check into the post game in the meantime, as they may be... oh, they're already staying out. Right? Yes. They're already coming out, so let's check through all of this here. Probably not that much of a surprise, Shelty. Playing quite competently, can see how much stronger the economy is having. Like double food almost. Gold kinda by a third, 2/3 more, something like that. Military count the same, 47, but difference in killed a bit. Due to the flaming weapons, 40 and 21. But it was finally solid, faster heroic for Joe as an ISIS on this map. And Shelty was just able to punish him anyway. Yeah, nice army, until it wasn't. And the difference in the total resources, quite big, about 6,000. Now 6,000 resources more. So, GG. And this is how you play it then, on hybrid mod or overall on vanilla, Thor versus an ISIS. Shelty, the master teacher.